Okay, here we're asked to graph one cycle of a cosecant curve. And so we can think back the standard cosecant curve. One cycle of it can be graphed over the period, or the interval rather, 0 to 2 pi, with the usual quarter marks, pi over 2 pi, 3 pi over 2. Okay, so if I want to get the new x's, I just set the argument of the cosecant equal to each of the original quarter marks. Now to solve each of these equations, I would be dividing by 3. So if I think from a transformational point of view, if I'm dividing the old x values by 3, that's a horizontal compression by a factor of 3. I get x equals 0, x equals pi over 6, x equals pi over 3, x equals pi over 2, x equals 2 pi over 3. And now I'll get the new y's, same as I did before. So for x equals 0, I look at y equal 2 cosecant 3 times 0 plus 1. This is 2 times the cosecant of 0. plus 1. Now, we think cosecant of something is 1 over sine of that thing. Since the sine of 0 is 0, the cosecant of 0 is undefined. That means we've got a vertical asymptote here. Substitute in x equals pi over 6. Y is 2 times the cosecant of 3 times pi over 6, which is 2 times the cosecant of pi over 2, oops, plus 1, forgot the plus 1s. The cosecant of pi over 2 is 1 over the sine of pi over 2. The sine of pi over 2 is 1, so I get 2 times 1 plus 1 is 3. For x equals pi over 3, I get y equal 2 times the cosecant of 3 times pi over 3 plus 1, which is 2 times the cosecant of pi plus 1. The cosecant of pi is 1 over the sine of pi, which would be 1 over 0. That means that the cosecant of pi is, once again, undefined. Producing another vertical asymptote. For x equals pi over 2, I get y equal 2 times the cosecant of 3 times pi over 2 plus 1. So it's 2 cosecant 3 pi over 2 plus 1. The cosecant of 3 pi over 2 is 1 over the sine of 3 pi over 2. The sine of 3 pi over 2 is negative 1. So I get 2 times negative 1 plus 1, which is negative 1. And to round it out, for x equals 2 pi over 3, I get y equal 2 times the cosecant of 3 times 2 pi over 3 plus 1, which is 2 times the cosecant of 2 pi plus 1, and this once again is undefined. So I've got an asymptote at 0, I've got 3 at pi over 6, an asymptote at pi over 3, a negative 1 at pi over 2, and another asymptote at 2 pi over 3. All right, so we've got the new x's and the new y's and the vertical asymptotes. So we start off here 0, pi over 6, pi over 3, pi over 2, and 2 pi over 3. And at 0, it was undefined, so we have a vertical asymptote there. So vertical asymptote, x equals 0. At pi over 6, we were up at y equals 3. At pi over 3, we had yet another vertical asymptote. At pi over 2, we were down at negative 1. So I'm going to move my label up here so it doesn't get in the way of the graph. And then at 2 pi over 3, we had another vertical asymptote. And remember, vertical asymptotes are lines. So you don't say the vertical asymptote is 0. You say the vertical asymptote is the line x equals 0. Okay, we know that the standard cosecant curve has these two branches to it, and there's always this gap. So that means that when we fill in the graph, we know the graph is going to hug the vertical asymptotes, but we want to fill these in so that there's this gap. And so we're going to do it this way then. So if I fill these in, then we're going to get the gap in the middle as we should. So we're getting this gap in the range of the function, which is what we should get. All right, as far as the period is concerned, and once again, the period is the length of the interval over which we can graph one cycle. The interval here we're graphing over is 0 to 2 pi, or excuse me, 0 to 2 pi over 3. So the period, I can just take the length of this interval. So I can take the right endpoint, 2 pi over 3, minus left endpoint, 0, and that gives me 2 pi over 3. So that'll do it for number 2.